Welcome to Power Electronics playlist. In this session, I'll be going to explain flyback converter with discontinuous mode of operation. So this is my circuit diagram that is there with flyback converter, and I'll be explaining this flyback converter with discontinuous mode. But before I explain discontinuous mode of this flyback converter operation, I'll be discussing about those elements which is there in this circuit. And once you understand how many elements are there with this circuit and what is that basic understanding which is required to understand this flyback converter, I think it is very easier to understand how flyback converter functions about. So here, first of all, I'll be talking about this transformer which is been used in this flyback converter. And winding of this transformer is not in the same direction. So when primary current is flowing, at that time secondary current will be zero, and when secondary current is flowing, at that time primary current is zero. So see, this is how its polarity is there. So opposite polarity is there. So if I say one dot is over here with magnetization of this inductor, then second dot that has to be over here. Now one more thing, here with this flyback converter we use high frequency transformer. So this transformer, that is high frequency transformer of ferrite core high frequency transformer. So here we use ferrite core high frequency transformer. And this transformer that provides isolation in between input and output. Here we take output and here we have DC input. So because of this transformer, we have isolation in between input and output. So input and output is isolated. And because of we have transformer which is isolating input and output, so we can have multiple output even. So we can have multiple output. So as I have told you, here basic speciality of this transformer is winding is not there in the same way. It is there in opposite way. So here by dot I am showing it. If primary current is flowing, at that time secondary current is not flowing, and when primary current is flowing, at that time when primary current is not flowing, at that time there will be demagnetization of this winding and secondary current will flow. So this is how winding is there. Now here one basic thing that we need to understand, here I have provided a switch, and this switch is been controlled by a circuit with signal. So here I will be giving pulses. So when pulse is on, at that time this switch is on, and when pulse is off, at that time this switch is off. So that is how this circuit functions about. Now let us try to understand how this circuit functions. So first case that I'll explain, what if this switch is on, and this is what primary winding and this is secondary winding. So as I have told, here we have DC battery connection. So this is plus and this is minus, and during positive pulse of this, this switch is on, and when this switch is on, current will flow in this loop, and that current will rise gradually. That current will rise gradually. So when this switch is on, current will rise gradually, and voltage across this switch VQ, that will be almost zero. So here in its functioning, here voltage across VQ, that is almost zero. The reason is Q is on, and when Q is on, this primary current IP, that will increase gradually. So primary current IP, that is increasing gradually like this. And at that time secondary current is zero. So secondary current is zero, and flux will increase gradually as current flows. So here I have shown flux, and flux will increase gradually as current increases gradually. I'll explain what is that VS voltage that is happening at output side. So that we'll talk later. So as this switch is on, primary current flows and it will increase gradually. So that is how functioning is happening, and current will flow in this loop. Now, second case, that is, what if this switch is off? So when this switch is off, this voltage of this inductor, so that was plus minus like this initially. Now it will change its polarity. That will be minus plus like this when this switch is off. So by round I have shown this polarity. When switch is on, at that time polarity is plus minus like this, but when switch is off, its polarity will be minus plus. So voltage, this switch is off, so voltage appear across VQ, that will be twice of almost EDC. So when switch is off, there will be almost twice of EDC voltage that will happen. So this is almost twice of EDC voltage, and here one can find little spike is there because of inductance of transformer. So spike that is happening because of inductance of transformer. And as I have told, when this switch is off, there will be a flow of current from this inductor at secondary side, and current will flow in this loop, and output that will be happening as plus minus. So this is what we have considered as a positive voltage, plus minus like this. So when switch is off, at that time primary current is almost zero, and voltage across this switch that is almost 2 EDC, and secondary current will flow. So secondary current that will be flowing, and it will decrease gradually, and that is what magnetization current in this transformer. So initially it will be maximum, and gradually as time passes by it will decrease gradually and it will get to zero. And here flux will decrease gradually, so flux is getting decreased gradually, and then there will be no secondary current. And as if no secondary current is there, the reason is secondary current is getting zero. So when secondary current that is getting zero, now there will be no supply that has been provided from secondary to load. So what will happen is voltage across capacitor, that will be EDC, which will appear at output side at the same instant. And once current is getting zero, so that will get to zero even. So now once this secondary current is zero and still switch is off, now primary voltage across this Q, that even will decrease, and it will happen by this EDC only. So in third mode of operation, here only EDC voltage that will appear, and when current is flowing at a time, 2 EDC voltage will appear, and primary current is zero, secondary current is even zero, and flux is even zero. Now case is, what will be this VS, that is output voltage over here. So when switch is off, at that time plus V voltage that is happening at output side, and when this switch is on, at that time minus V voltage that will appear at output side. So ultimately when switch is off, at that time minus V voltage that will appear at output side, and when this switch is on, at that time this plus V voltage will appear at output side. But once current is zero, output voltage will get to zero. So if we see over here, there is nothing at output side once secondary current that is zero. So here secondary current is 0, and one can see output voltage is 0, so output voltage is 0 as well as secondary current is 0, so this is where it is getting discontinued. So that's why it is what discontinuous mode of operation. So basically this circuit functions in three different mode. In mode 1, this switch is on. So this is what mode 1 operation, where switch is on, and at that time voltage across switch is 0. Primary current will increase gradually, secondary current will be 0, output voltage will be minus V, and flux will increase gradually. In second mode, switch is off. In second mode, switch is off. So secondary current will flow and it will decrease to 0. At that time, output voltage will be plus V, and flux will decrease gradually and it will become 0. And in third mode of operation, switch is off, but secondary current is 0, primary current is 0, output voltage is 0, and flux is even 0. So this is where output is getting discontinued. There will be 0 voltage and 0 current at load side. So this is what third mode of operation. So this is what flyback converter with discontinuation mode, and it is operating in three mode. In first mode, switch is on, voltage across switch is 0, primary current is flowing like this, polarity of inductor will be plus minus like this, and secondary current will be 0, and output across secondary, output voltage, that will be minus Vs at that time, and flux will increase gradually. Once switch is off, inductor will change its polarity, voltage across switch during switch is off, that will be almost 2 eDC, and secondary current will flow at that time, that will result into plus V voltage at load side, and secondary current will decrease gradually as this inductor is getting de-energized at secondary side. And once inductor current is 0, then output voltage will be even 0, and in third mode of operation, output voltage is 0, secondary current is 0, so that is where output is getting discontinued. So this is how waveforms are there. During switch is on, output voltage is 0, during switch is off, it will be almost 2 eDC, there will be little spike because of inductor, and primary current is 0, secondary current will decrease gradually, and flux is even getting decreased gradually, and once secondary current and secondary voltage is getting 0, output voltage is getting discontinued. Now let us discuss few advantages of this flyback converter with discontinued mode. So in flyback converter with discontinued mode, it requires slower diodes. So slower diodes could be used in discontinued mode. The reason is duty cycle is below 0.5. Duty cycle, that is below 0.5, that's why it requires slower diode. Second advantage is small size of transformer is used. Small size of transformer is used. Third advantage is it does not require additional filter like inductor filter, and that is required in continuous mode. I will explain that in next session. So it does not require additional filter. And another advantage is fast transient response. So fast transient response is happening. So this is fourth advantage. and there are few disadvantages which is there with this circuit. One disadvantage is it requires high peak current rating of devices. It requires high peak current rating. Now, second disadvantage is it requires large size of capacitor. And third disadvantage is maximum duty cycle is 50%. So maximum duty cycle is 50% in discontinuous mode. So this is what disadvantage which is there. It requires high peak current rating of devices, like this diode requires to have high peak current rating. This capacitor size will be more and duty cycle will be maximum 50%. So these three disadvantages are there. High peak current rating of this diode, large size of capacitor and maximum 50% duty cycle is there with discontinuous mode. And advantage is we can have slower diode, small size of transformer. It does not require additional L filter. We don't need L filter over here. And it has fast transient response. So these are the advantage which is there with this discontinuous mode of operation with flyback converter. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can suggest me those videos which is required to complete power electronics. If I have understanding based on those topics, definitely I will upload videos based on your suggestions. Thank you so much for watching this video.